Hi, hunting.net. I'm Daniel Noah. I'm one of the partners and director of development at Spectrevision, and we are working with Ubisoft to make a game called Transference.
And I'm Kyle McCullough. I'm the vice president of digital at Spectrevision, and we are working collaboratively to make a game with Ubisoft called Transference.
I just said that.
It's a psychological thriller that takes the research of a great scientist and sort of explores the concepts of consciousness and technology, and allows you to experience things within virtual reality or a standard system that sort of implicate all of the ideas of forthcoming virtual technologies.
Understand that. Well, I think the story of Transference is best experienced in the game. But what we will say is what we have released so far is the demo, which has been widely seen now at various conventions. And the story behind the demo is that there is a new technology developed by a neuroscientist named Raymond Hayes, in which the consciousness and memories of a subject are uploaded into a virtual reality space. And you, as the player, are able to enter these experiences and kind of roam around and explore them and examine them to try and understand the emotional states and psyches of the people whose minds you are essentially entering.
Yeah, so, I mean, I don't know how much I can say about it, but part of the idea of jumping back and forth in time in the Transference demo is the idea that someone's consciousness in this virtual realm would be an amassing of all of their consciousness over time. So it wouldn't just be a simple slice of their history, it would actually be fully experiential within all of their consciousness.
Non-linear.
So
the way we remember.
Right. So it sort of plays with that idea of examining someone's memories from within their own consciousness the way that they might examine or remember their memories.
The demo is indeed a prelude to the full game, and I think that what we really endeavored to do in the demo is to try and recreate the mind of a singular subject. And so the way that we built it was, how do we remember and how do we experience our own lives? There are many mysteries in the way that we remember our own experiences. And so we tried to represent that very much in the demo. It is widely open to interpretation. We believe it's all there. And there are people who played the demo who we've been very impressed have come out and fully decoded the events that are represented. But I think the important thing is that whether you fully understand them on a literal level or not, the experience is very intense. It's emotional. It's tactile. It is primarily a sensory experience, not an intellectual one.
Yeah, so for us, we explored a lot of VR that has been sort of bubbling up over the last couple years, and it was really important to us that we tell a story in virtual reality that was not a passive experience, that had to be engaging, that would attempt to engage the player on a number of levels, physically, mentally, emotionally, and make them feel like they were actually part of the story instead of just sort of watching something unfold in front of them. So we didn't want to tell a narrative in virtual reality any other way than having it actually be a physically engaging process where you are essentially, you're a character in the story that you are experiencing. I think that sort of ties, the idea that there's puzzles in the game sort of ties back into making it engaging on as many levels as possible. So to fully engage somebody in virtual reality, a really easy way is to revert to basic gaming techniques. Since this idea of sort of merging virtual reality and narrative, we couldn't even begin to do without a company like Ubisoft. And so they bring a huge wealth of knowledge of gaming, you know, over decades. And so taking a lot of those ideas and using the idea of just a puzzle, which we're constantly solving puzzles every day when we're just sort of trying to figure out how to live our lives, and trying to take those puzzles and make them impactful in some way, so that the puzzle is the story, is the game, is the emotional content of the experience. And so that was a big goal in all of our construction of puzzles, and the idea of puzzles as a way to sort of get further in the experience, or sort of understand something more, so that you're not just solving a puzzle for the sake of like, oh, this is fun, even though hopefully they all are really fun, but they also have an impact on the player to help them actually engage with the narrative.
The game is slated for release in spring of 2018. And will be available for VR and all
traditional
all systems, and also traditional platforms.
Yeah, because that was another important piece of this, was that we want to tell a story about virtual reality, but that you don't actually have to have virtual reality hardware to play the story and fully understand it.
When Ubisoft approached us about this collaboration, the premise was, how can we take the best of what we do as filmmakers and the best of what they do as game designers and fuse those elements together to create something that can't be done purely in cinema and can't be done purely in gaming. And it's been an amazing experience in which we're constantly challenging each other and learning from each other. And in many ways, it functions like a ping pong ball game. Like, they'll do a pass, they'll lob it to us, we'll do a pass, we lob it to them, it goes back and forth and back and forth, and the result is something that we hope and feel is very unique. It does have the immersive qualities of cinema, and I think, you know, as we've explored and tried to understand what VR has to offer, more and more we feel it is very much like entering a dream, and which is really something that cinema tends to do very well, maybe more so than gaming, which tends to be a more intellectual experience. So we're, as Kyle said earlier, the gaming aspects of Transference are, they're not just about scoring points and collecting objects, just, you know, so that you watch your numbers go up or your inventory grow. The puzzle and gaming aspects are ways of getting under the skin of the characters. So you're constantly burrowing deeper into their psyches, understanding them better, how they think, how they feel, what they want, what they care about, what they're afraid of. And so you, ideally, as a player, you feel that you are an active protagonist in a movie. You're not playing another character. You're not passively watching another character. You are the character in a film. The team consists of two very small, tight knit units. On our side, it's the Spectrevision team. We're a small crew. We work together on movies and television stuff, and now we're working together on this. And on the Ubisoft side, it's the Funhouse division, which is their specialty division, which is has been purposed specifically to try and push boundaries and do things that are a little more progressive. I guess you could say it's like focus is to universal. What's the right? Yeah, you could say it's like focus features is to universal, a specialty label. So they're a very small team. We're a very small team. We fly back and forth and have these wonderful, you know, week long sessions where we put a million cards up on the wall and restructure everything and add layers, and it's a very intimate, very pleasurable collaboration. I think that, you know, I think the virtual reality is really in its infancy, and I think a lot of what's been out there so far has been really dazzling and impressive, and in some ways it's sort of like the equivalent of the Lumiere film of watching the train, when the beginning of cinema, when people would, you know, plop down a nickel and just marvel at the fact that a train is moving on a screen, and my God, it's just marveling at the existence of a new technology. And I think what we really tried to do is that, you know, one of the very first conversations we had was, okay, what's step two after we get over the novelty, and what's step three and step four? Let's fast forward as many generations as we can past the sense of discovery to start actually making things that are mature in the medium. And I think as we've started to walk along that really untrodden path, we ourselves are overwhelmed by the possibilities of virtual reality. It's not like gaming. It's not like cinema. It really is its own animal, and the possibilities are incredible. I've said before, and I'll say again, in my opinion, it actually has more in common with novels than it does with any other medium. A novel exists entirely in your brain. And virtual reality has a weird way of burrowing into your consciousness and kind of unfolding inside your mind in a way that I've never had with a film, or rarely had with films. I mean, maybe some of the greatest filmmakers, like Kubrick and Tarkovsky, and ways I've very rarely had in gaming, but have had with great literature. And so I think the potential is just enormous and so exciting.
Yeah, it's really interesting to think about the fact that with the Lumiere train film, like, people jumped out of their way.
They thought they were being run over by the train.
Yeah. And you know, nowadays you can watch a train video on your phone or on those TV. You can go to a theater, you can see it, and no one is jumping out of the way. No one believes that this train could actually come and out of the screen and hurt them in any way. We're past that. But with virtual reality, we kind of get given that tool anew and fresh. You know, if you put someone in virtual reality who's afraid of heights and you put them on top of a building, they're going to be terrified. I don't know if there's anybody on this particular couch that experienced something like this, but
it really tricks your senses into thinking it's really happening. And it's been a little sadistic, but it's kind of exciting when we watch people doing the demo to watch them scream and tear the unit off their head because they're actually feeling that they're in danger. It's amazing. And they are.
Yeah. Or are they? They're completely safe.
Completely safe.
Completely safe.
We hope that you enjoy Transference.